Hello and welcome to the Gray Room. Today we're going to take a look at a 2010 San Diego Comic-Con exclusive. It is a Star Wars McQuarrie Concept bust of Darth Vader. It's a pretty cool bust from General Giant, and I've said before that I like the concept art because it kind of gives you an idea of the thought progression and how they came up with the final product that we actually see in the movie. Now, if you like concept art, or if you like bust or Star Wars stuff, I think you're going to like this item, so let's go ahead and take a look. Okay, let's start by taking a look at the box. First of all, thing to notice is that the box is really, really shiny, almost a mirror reflective capability there. You can see the camera in it. It's so shiny, which I thought is pretty cool for a cardboard box to be that shiny. We get a window here, look at Darth Vader inside. Star Wars logo. It says Darth Vader McQuarrie Concept Collectible Mini Bust. We have the General Giant logo here. And then at the top of the box, it says San Diego Comic-Con Exclusive 2010. Now, this bust does come with three interchangeable heads. And on the side of the box, we get a look at one of the heads here from the front angle. With him looking to the side there with the Star Wars logo on the bottom. On the other side, we get to look at one of the other heads from a little different angle of the bust. And as you notice, Darth Vader's sword is blue here. And so that's part of the concept. They ended up obviously with a red lightsaber with the Star Wars logo down here on the bottom. Now, on the back of the box, we get another look at some of the concept art from McQuarrie. And this is a Luke Skywalker and Darth Vader battle. And so you get a little look at some of the concept art of Luke Skywalker there. You get a look at two of the heads that are interchangeable there. And it actually says, features three interchangeable heads, each molded after the original pencil stencils. Then we have this paragraph here that says, though uniquely different from that of the final screen version, this Darth Vader concept piece still holds true to the end result of the timeless helmet and black armor. Often credited with developing the look and feel of Star Wars trilogy, Ralph McQuarrie and Joe Johnson worked side by side developing this version of Darth Vader. Based on the original early drawings from Star Wars A New Hope, this minibus shows a fascinating look at the conceptual development for the Dark Lord of the Sith. This highly detailed minibus, based on the original Lucasfilm costumes and props, was sculpted and hand-painted by General Giant LTD. We hope you enjoy it. And I do. Now, the bottom of the box shows the General Giant logo with the barcode. And right here, it has that it's number 1262 of 2500, so it is a limited piece. And now we'll go ahead and open it up and take a look at the bust itself. Okay, one of the first things we see when we open the box is it has the General Giant website right there. And then whenever we open it up, inside it has the certificate of authenticity showing that this is a limited edition, number 1262 of 2500. And that's taped right to the product. Okay, once we got it out of the box, we start to open it up here. You can see it has the General Giant logo right here in the styrofoam. Then we see the mini bust here all packaged up. Shows one of the figureheads already attached, and then two of the other interchangeable heads, and then the lightsaber over here. So let's pull this out and see how it goes together. So here's a look at the bust itself, and right away you can tell many of the differences between this version and the final screen version. You can definitely see his front pack has no buttons or lights on it, his belt, his shoulder pads, even the flow of his rest of his costume is a little different. The helmet is definitely differently shaped. But it has very great detail, and I really like this bust for the detail that it has in the gloves, his uniform. And in the backside, you can see the detail and the flow of his robe. You can definitely see detail in his gloves. And if we turn him around here and we get the lightsaber, can put that on. You can get a look at that. And like I said before, you know, it has the blue lightsaber there instead of the red one. That's part of the concept. And then, of course, they ended up with a red lightsaber. And then if we take a look at the bottom of the bust, it says, you know, General Giant, Star Wars, Darth Vader, McQuarrie Concept, limited edition number 1262 of 2500. So that is on the bust as well. And it's got a really good weight to it. And so I really like this bust a lot. So now let's go ahead and take the helmet off, and we will take a look at the three interchangeable helmets that it has. So the first one that we had on has a very thin mouthpiece, and it's very elongated, and it comes out quite a bit. And if you can tell here, it has a very accentuated brow line in the helmet, and it comes down to a point right there. The back of the helmet is very similar to the final. It's not quite as down as the final one. It's a little more short, and then it also has some lines and ridges on the back of the helmet there. So that's the first one. The next one has even a more accentuated brow, and it comes down to quite a bit more of a point. The eyes are a little more almond shaped, and again with the thin type mouth piece area, and it's not quite as elongated as the first one there, but it does have more of a line here coming off the chin area. And I don't know if you can see a definite indent in here in the sides of the helmet, and it's also got some ridges and things like that in the side of the helmet. And then this is more of an oval shaped helmet there. Try to give you a look at it. The third one is probably the closest one to the final version. This has more of the long helmet look to the back of it, completely smooth. It does have a little more of an accentuated brow than the final version, and the mouth guard here is a little more wider and not quite as snout-like or accentuated as the other two. And the eyes on this one here are a little closer together, and there's a little more detail in the cheeks of the mask there. But still a little bit different than the final screen version, but probably the closest one. And one of the cool things with the helmets is, as you put them on the bust, you can actually turn them and pose them in a little bit different poses, so that's pretty cool. So overall, it's a very good bust, has a good weight, good detail, and again, you know, it has the three interchangeable helmets. And that does it for this review of the McQuarrie Concepts Darth Vader mini bust.